So the next speaker is Professor Sosnowski from Świerk, and his talk title is Influence of Quantized Vortex Dynamics on Superconducting Electronics. Professor, welcome. Please give a talk.
Okay. Excuse me for not a good start. I will present small achievements, but my achievements. related to the topic of vortex dynamics and its influence on superconducting electronics. Please, next slide. Okay, further, please. Okay. Still next. Superconducting materials exhibit quantum phenomena on a macroscopic scale. The most evident examples are quantized vortices transporting magnetic flux. The communication will be discussed as the influence of Pankage vortices in HTC superconductors on IV curves and critical current, which are the essential parameters characterizing superconducting electronic quantum devices. It will be shortly also discussed the influence of this vortex dynamics on the power superconducting apparatus in which construction I participated, superconducting magnets and current leads. Please, next slide. So, vortex dynamics influences the current carrying properties of superconductors, leading to low endurance of HTC superconductors on applied magnetic field. What is seen in IV characteristics measured on synthesized me IBC quo. So it's seen here that even small magnetic field decreases critical current very significantly. So therefore it arises problem how to avoid this problem and this effect, and it is connected tightly with just vortex dynamics. Please, next slide, give. Especially this very large sensitivity of critical current and generally IV characteristics is important in HTC superconductors, which are multi-layered superconductors, and what leads to anisotropy of these materials. Please, next slide. Capturing of nano defects in a multi-layered structure of HT superconductors is shown in this slide. And here is also shown that these vortices interact between layers. So it's a multi-layered interaction because magnetic field crossing the middle plane induces currents and therefore also vortices in surrounding planes. And it's important that the direction of these currents are different in surrounding planes in comparison to this essential middle plane. So it means that vortices in neighboring planes attract, while vortices in the same plane repulse. Please, next slide, give. And as it was shown, vortices are the dynamics of vortices is connected with spinning problems. It is interaction of nano defects with vortices. And here is shown an example of creation of nano defect by irradiation. Please, next slide. So energy balance has been constructed similar in some sense to Gibbs-Landau free energy, restricted to the vortex part, captured on nano-sized pinning centers. And it was considered the case of shift of magnetic vortex from initial position, the delta R, under influence of Lorentz and the elasticity forces. Please, next slide. And here is shown the scanning electron microscopy photographs of the cross section of HTC's superconducting tape, where these nano defects are evidently seen as a black point, black dots. Please, next slide. So the model was constructed, how these vortices, here represented by vortex core, by normal part of these vortices, interact with nano defect of rectangular on left side and cylindrical on right side. And if these vortices cross to the nano defect, so total energy of normal part decreases because geometrically then is smaller total region of normal part in comparison to superconducting. So any pinning potential arises, which for this circular nano defect is expressed in the bottom part of this slide. Please, next slide. And three initial vortex positions were considered. It is of a pancake vortex captured on nano defects on the depth coherence length xi, which is preferable for larger nano defects, as it was shown previously. Here is this shown on this slide the geometry of capturing vortex on a nano defect of with d smaller than coherence length, than radius, than vortex core for halfly captured vortex. And then at the bottom is shown the potential energy of such interaction in this initial state. Please, next slide. And of course, if you have potential energy, we can calculate forces of interaction depending on as a derivative simply. Depending on depth of position vortex in the nano defect. And because this potential energy varies with movement of increases with movement of pancake vortex, then potential barrier, of course, arises. So this potential barrier is shown at the bottom equation. Please, next slide. Here is this potential barrier, including already Lorentz forces interaction. And this potential barrier brings any maximum, achieves any maximum delta in for deflection of vortex on the depth xm, which is here expressed. Please, next slide. And additionally, here is included elasticity forces of the vortex lattice, because of course, if vortex is pinned, then he shifts from equilibrium position in hexagonal vortex lattice, and it gives to additional elasticity energy as is shown in the upper equation. And finally, it leads to a new expression for potential barrier already in current representation is function of I, where I is reduced transport current, reduced to critical. And then potential barrier is given in next equation, taking into account this interaction elasticity. Please, next slide. Here is shown how this potential barrier decreases with reduced current with this parameter I, which is J divided by JC, for three values of elasticity forces. Please, next slide. Previously, it was discussed the halfly captured vortex, but this model was of course extended on other geometries. It is for fully here is shown the case of fully captured vortex when vortex fully penetrates nanodefect. Please, next slide. And also intermediate position of the captured punctate vortex was considered. Please, next slide. So finally, we obtain for these three initial states the potential barriers. As a function of deflection, it means in current representation as function of I, it means reduced transport current. For these three discussed cases. And it's essential idea of this approach that this obtaining to this potential barrier height. And when we have potential barrier, then we calculate already the current voltage characteristics according to this flux creep equation. So both for forward and the backward flux creep processes. Flux creep, of course, is a process of movement of vortices. For smaller currents than flux flow. So it's previous stage. Please, next slide. Now here is shown the initial of position of captured vortex on a reduced current versus potential barrier for three positions, initial position. The first is fully captured, half captured, and intermediate state. Please, next slide. So finally, we obtain IV curves. Now, here is shown as function of magnetic induction. And of course, current critical current decreases with magnetic induction, as is shown in from these curves. Please, next slide. But because there are multilayer structure, so of course, as we have shown before, it should be taken into account also the between planes, and here is shown how critical current, or more precisely IV curves, are varying if taking it into account n interacting planes. So it's in here that for more interacting planes, critical current decreases. But it decreases, of course, in this sense that it's critical current in one plane. But so if you take 10 plane, 9 plane, of course, it will be larger total critical current. But in individual plane, this interlayer interaction decreases critical current. Please, next slide. Of course, and the theoretical model should be verified by an experiment, and it is shown here, and it is in quite good agreement between model and points which represent experimental data. And of course, from this fitting procedure are obtained average size and inherent concentration of defects of the range 10 to 10 per square centimeter. Because we investigate irradiation, in the radiational type defects, which gives any concentration on surface. Please, next slide. Now here is shown how this model applies to superconducting tapes. And here is also quite good agreement obtained versus temperature. Of course, there are quite many larger currents because this is superconducting tapes. So currents are of the range 100 amps. And the solid lines are theoretical models. Please, next slide, give. And the model predicts to the influence of nanodefects diameter on critical current versus concentration of neutrons. Please, next slide. And of course, here is shown it's a function of elasticity coefficient of vortex lattice. It's shown this dependence of critical current versus irradiation dose. A stronger is elasticity forces in vortex lattice, then critical current is smaller. No, because of course there are needed there more forces to move vortex to pinning center from equilibrium hexagonal lattice. Please, next slide. And really such results of increase of initial increase of critical current with bombardment were observed for the case of neutrons, havions, and also others experiment were made, which initially really increased critical current. Please, next slide. The model was applied also to case of bending strain, not only radiation, but to defects made by bending strain, created bending strain, which is the case of winding of any superconducting coils or something such. So this model is closely connected with apparatus, with superconducting apparatus, because it's case of coil, and previously it was tape. Of course, during the bending strain, it's defects are in the form of micro cracks, as you see here. Micro cracks, not columnar defect, but micro cracks. Please give next slide. So, and the model was of multifilamentary type with ordered micro cracks as couplet to long lines of resistors describing filament in resistive states, deformed and undeformed by existence of micro cracks was elaborated. Please, next slide. And then finally, now it was obtained expressions for IV curves versus bending strain, parameter A, it's bending strain. Please, next slide. So it's in here how this theoretical current voltage characteristic of superconducting tapes are the function of bending strain. By any shape of rupture probability function. So it's in that with increasing bending strain, critical current decreases. It's curve one. Please, next slide. And it is in comparison with experimental data, where also measured on BISCO tape, where also for 1% bending strain, critical current is much smaller than for pure tape. Please, next slide. Also, model predicts the flux pinning dependence on magnetic induction, which is in good relation with experimental data. Please give next slide. So previously was theoretical flux pinning versus induction. Here is experimental. So it looks quite similarly. And especially interesting is that others models give this value of maximum for 0.6, 0.5. It's this vertical axis. But in experimental, this maximum is at 0.4, 0.2. And my model allows to obtain these maximal values just for the smaller values of magnetic induction, reduced magnetic induction of the range 0.4. Others model give, in my opinion, 0.6, for instance. Please, next slide. So we have described the vortex dynamics in static case. But especially interesting is dynamical case. It is dynamical, then we have observed dynamical anomalies measured on IV curves of EBCO superconductor in a linearly slowly varying magnetic field. And then these anomalies are observed. This next slide, which are function of magnetic field sweep rate, current, frequency magnetic field, and a few others, temperature. And therefore, this model was extended on the dynamic penetration of vortices, as is here seen, and diffusion equation was investigated. This next slide. And then are obtained an expression for generated electric field during magnetic field variation. It's B dot. It's velocity of magnetic field variation. This next slide. For saturated and unsaturated regions. First line is for unsaturated region, and second line is for saturated region.
I have one question in regard to this slide. So do we have some critical components? Because we have some power, 1 over 1 plus y. So is it like critical exponents here?
In some cases, yes. I can say it's material coefficient. Material coefficient, but of course there are critical. They change between 0 to 1. So in any region only these anomalies appear.
Okay, thanks. It's just first association of this fact. I would say it has something to do with critical exponents. But anyway. Mm-hmm. Thanks for an answer.
Mm-hmm. The next slide, can I see?
Yeah. 1 second.
It's calculated dependence of the shape of the dynamical anomalies on IV characteristics in varying magnetic field on the transport current. And really, this model based on diffusion penetration of vortices of sample leads to such anomalies which we have observed. And really, it increases with current. Please, next slide. No, it's just dependence of these anomalies on velocity on the magnetic diffusion coefficient D of penetration vortices into superconductor. Please, next slide. Here are measured dynamical anomalies for various values of linearly varying. So it's experimental results. For various values of magnetic field sweep. Please, next slide. And it's a model. So also this shift is observed. So finally, please, next slide. It can be said that these anomalies can be used as superconducting sensor. So it's just electronic topic of using superconductivity and this vortex dynamics. Please, next slide. Now here we come to other problems of Josephson junctions, where vortex dynamics is also important subject. Here shown vortex penetrating Josephson junctions. It's vortex is described by this modified Sina-Gordon equation. And in the language of the Sina-Gordon equation, it's soliton then, which rotating during current and magnetic field composition emits radiation. Please, next slide. And here also appears the influence of defects, because here appears in the second equation lambda t. It means Ginzburg lambda penetration length, which is sensitive just to free electron distance and A, and this A, as is shown in the lower left line, is inversely proportional to defect concentration, to square root of defect concentration. So here also these effects of defects and vortex dynamics plays important role for predicting the velocity, the frequency of irradiated microwaves. This next slide. No, here is some second architecture of such vortex, of such Josephson junctions with vortices emitting light of the type Eiffel junction, Eiffel Tower. This next slide. So this in macroscopic scale, this vortex dynamics effects will influence the work of superconducting cryocouple and coil, as shown below, a small model of cryocouple for 20 kilovolts constructed with me previously. Please next slide. And then appears the hysteresis behavior of critical current. Magnetic induction distribution profiles in the bulk superconductor for the first and next ramps, the transport electric current of the amplitude I am flowing in the superconductor of the sickness to air is shown here. And this vortex dynamics, therefore, because it's effect of vortex dynamics, of vortex penetration, this curve presents schematically the shape of magnetic induction in superconducting, for instance, current leads or generally superconducting wire versus hysteresis of magnetic induction. And it's observed large influence of this vortex dynamics on this hysteresis. What it means, it's influence on losses. Please next slide. Here are shown the losses generated in such superconducting wire for various cases. It is for first increase of current, and then for second and next ramps. And it's observed here large hysteresis. In first rise, it's these are these upper curves, while next ramps are curves below. So it means that in this case, it's obtained a well-known effect of improving superconducting coils by a few ramping of current or even by quenching. Please next slide. Now here is shown how this vortex dynamics influences the current leads. Here are shown the cuprum current leads and losses generated in this cuprum current leads, or more closely in cool part of flowing through cool part of current leads, and down curve is for superconducting current leads. So it's seen the difference in respect to generation of losses. Please next slide. And then more about this problems of cryocouples is prepared in my book, which of course I recommend. Please next slide. And finally, for the discussed on workshop collaboration between superconducting and semiconducting devices can be helpful for superconducting semiconductors as lanthanum selenide, which I measured years before. It's a critical temperature versus concentration and magnetization versus concentration of carrier, electron carriers. Please, next slide. So I come to conclusion. It was reviewed the model of vortex dynamics in multilayered superconductors based on the capturing interaction, leading to pinning potential barrier correction and the influencing work of superconducting sensoring devices. The comparison of the model calculation with the experiment characteristics in static magnetic field has been performed, as well as dynamic case was regarded. It's especially interesting because it allows this dynamic case to propose superconducting sensor determining electromagnetic parameters of superconductors connected with the diffusion velocity of magnetic flux. The influence of vortex dynamics on Josephson based devices was discussed briefly, as well as on superconducting cryocables. Thank you for attention.
Thank you for a nice talk. So let us have the questions to the speakers. So please ask your questions. So maybe I will have the first question. So you have presented on one slide. You have presented the bended cable, superconducting cable. So how it's possible? I mean, I know that at low temperatures the materials can break very easily. So if you bend superconducting cable, you introduce defects. So this is irreversible process, right?
Certainly, of course. There appear micro cracks, and then this. So it is such. It's a critical volume of this bending where it's an elastic process. It means that micro cracks still not appear. And it's about 0.1%. It's still a reversible region. And then micro cracks are not created yet. But for values larger than this critical bending, then of course appear micro cracks, and then it's irreversible process. Of course.
So maybe I have another question. So let us go to the equation of you derive various equations for forces. Maybe I will come to the slide which you show. So so because here I already make the comment about the critical exponents present. Could you describe a little bit more on the philosophy of derivation of this vortex, of the force concept? So there's a force acting on the vortex, and the first question is, can you assign a mass to a vortex? Because there are some theories in which says that vortex has no mass, and there are theories that says that vortex has a mass. And second thing is, could you make a more comment on details of the derivation?
Yes, so it's only part of Ginzburg-Landau free energy related to of system energy. No, it can be such said related only to pinning effects, to capturing effects. It means interaction of vortices between them. It's the second term. First term is pinning interaction. No, third term is interaction of vortices with through Lorentz forces, because vortices give currents, and it's in magnetic field, so it appears this Lorentz forces. And of course, this interaction leads to movement of to shift of vortex on any distance delta r on small distance. And last part is connected with elasticity forces of vortex lattice, because of course if we restrict only to these pinning interactions, then we see that vortices form a regular lattice, as shown Abrikosov, hexagonal, for instance. But if it's an capturement, ensuring of vortices, it means that this vortex I, because it's n vortices here is discussed. So given a vortex, for instance, indexed I, moves from this equilibrium position in hexagonal vortices lattice, and the energy of this elasticity energy increases because it moves from this equilibrium position. And it's sign minus, because then the pinning interaction is decreasing. For instance, we have an vortex lattice very strong, very stiff, then it will be now movement of vortex from this lattice, and it will be no pinning and therefore no critical current. All lattice will flow regularly with current.
I see. Okay, do we have any other questions? Maybe I will have one more, since we still have some time till next presentation.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Hello. First of all, it was quite an interesting presentation. I would like to inquire if we have examined whether or not the solution of the equations do hint towards an existence of an attractor, a hidden attractor, or any type of chaotic behavior.
It was a question to me?
Yes.
Could you repeat, because I have lost contact.
Yes, of course. First of all, it was quite an interesting presentation, and I would like to inquire of whether or not the solutions to the system provide any hint towards the existence of any hidden attractor that might lead to any type of chaotic behavior.
On my level of this investigation, I didn't consider your problem.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you.
I can try to answer your question. So Japanese has already developed the microscope, a kind of microscope that shows the vortex movement in real time. And this vortex dynamics, vortex liquids. Okay, so there is very long paper, review paper by Blatter, Review of Modern Physics. It's one of the longest paper I have ever read. It's like more than 270 pages. So it describes title is high temperature vortices in high temperature superconductors. So this paper gives you methodology, various methodological tools to tackle with dynamics of moving vortices. The problem is that moving vortex is already a system out of equilibrium. So in its core, there are quasi-particles. And when they move, they dissipate energy. So actually, this is a quantum system with certain level of dissipation. And to be very honest, it's absolutely a nightmare to treat things very fundamentally. So the talk which was given just describes vortex dynamics, a kind of approximated vortex dynamics by means of Ginzburg-Landau theory. But you can dig in much deeper. You can go to Bogdanovich-Jens equation, BCS equations. You can go to Keldysh green functions, non-equilibrium green functions techniques, and so on, so on. So this is a very rich topic. So I would say if vortex move very slowly, the system is a little bit out of equilibrium. So still can be treated theoretically. Otherwise, it becomes so complicated that nobody can tackle that. So that's what I'm trying to tell you. And also, if you deal with vortex dynamics, you deal with time-dependent Ginzburg-Landau equation, and there are certain coefficients proportional to time derivative. It's the coefficient times time derivative of psi. So anyway, there's a lot of work already done and a lot of complications to come across. So I'm sure there is some certain level of chaotic behavior in a certain regime, but that's very long, very wide topic. So just to let you know. Yep.
Yes, a comment. So there are also lots of quantum-like effects observed for because of vortices, like tunneling, interference, Dabbitt experiment, Aharonov-Bohm time experiments. I have put some references in the chat.
Oh, thank you so much. Yeah. So actually, there is a concept of particle. Actually, there is a lot of work like by Franco Nori. So some people use vortex as a low dimensional quantum field theory that is modeling the particle presence. Yeah, and as Dr. Jarek Duda mentioned, vortex can also tunnel via Josephson junction, for example, and so on and so on. So this is a very rich topic. So yeah. Obviously, we do expect certain level of kind of deterministic chaos behavior in certain regime, but one needs to find out by himself from certain perspective, since it's hard to say.